You were also vice chairman of the Nigeria Football Association between 1985 and 1991. Are you happy with the state of football in Nigeria currently?
State of football in Nigeria is dead. The organization is dead. In the olden days, I was the chairman, maybe you may remember, apart from being the vice chairman, I was the chairman of the disciplinary council, committee of the NFA. And we decide cases of dispute or disagreement effectively and fast. And everything was going well. We also have white coaches. And I mean white coaches. You see, there is no way you can respect our coaches in Nigeria. You go there to the ministry, you want a football. You want something for your boys. They may not answer you. Bureaucracy. The form of way we society in Nigeria. If they see a white man, skin man standing before them, asking for the welfare of the footballers, they will answer him. But if you get a white man, or even a black Brazilian, we will get authority. It will not be biased on the choice of who are going to play, or how long you are playing, when he finds that you are not doing well. It will have no hesitation to replace you. So with all these combinations, we are yet young to say that we are mature enough to produce footballers who can now be coaches. We are very, very young in that regard. I'm not particular about color or skin. I'm particular about experience and credibility. You know, things will move better. And then our coaches that we have brought up, they are good, like CSR and others. But once I glued myself to the television, I can see they are not reading the game. They don't, our coaches don't know how to read the game. The boys dictate the game. So me, because I was very involved in football, I feel sometimes not well when I'm seeing Nigerian football being played.
I'll start this next question with this quote. Muslims and Christians together make up well over half of the world's population. Without peace and justice between these two religious communities, there can be no meaningful peace in the world. And the future of the world depends on peace between Muslims and Christians. That is a quote from A Common Word Between Us and You, an open letter by leaders of Islam to Christian churches everywhere, of which you were one of the 138 signatories. What do you think was achieved by that effort?
Well, the effort was made. But the main effort that is most admirable and good was that of General Obasanjo, or President Obasanjo, let me say. He called Nigerian Interreligious Council. That one was very, very effective.
Finding common ground between Muslims and Christians is not really simply a matter for polite ecumenical dialogue between selected religious leaders. What more should we be doing to promote interfaith harmony?
The constitution, as you know, we have now. Nigeria is not a religious entity. Religion, there are many religions in Nigeria. It's a multi-religious country. That one is good. That aspect is good. So there's no bias for or against either of the Christians or the Muslims. And then in the case of Western religion, you can see in Western religion, every family, they are both Muslims and Christians. They can never fight.
But by the way, Your Highness, do you really believe that the crisis in Nigeria is religious? And is Nigeria as polarized along religious lines as some people try to make us believe?
The whole thing started for a certain administration where they insisted that when one is a Muslim and is the leader, the deputy must be a Christian. Before that time, we didn't have that kind of problem. You take when Awolowo was premier of the West, his deputy was Adegbenro, so they are in the same kind of religion. Akintola was also a Christian. Nobody looked for whether you're a Christian. One day I came here, I met some Christians, and I said to them, before I tell you what I call you for, I want to tell you that in the morning I was hearing one radio, and he was singing a song, and he was saying, Ayebaje o, etetebo, Christ etetebo, Christ, please come home. God, this world is bad. So come and effect changes for us. Come and correct this world, etc. Then I said to them, when I heard the thing again, I sat down on my bed so that I could hear it very well. Now he said, who is the Christ that is coming? Olugbala, the one to correct the ills of the world. I said, but that which is in the Bible is also in the Quran. The Muslims are expecting Jesus Christ, called Musa, to come back and redress these ills, to come and correct these inequities, come and change the world for better. So the two religions are expecting the same thing. I say, if that is so, why should you be coming here to tell me you want to preserve the Christian school for only Christians and for not non-Muslims? We should be together. But it all depends on how you look at it. When I got to this state as Emir Pilone, some people were not all that easy. They thought I'm a religious beggar, just coming to fight Islam. But when they related with me for some time, they now know that my name is Abraham, the father of all religions. So I feel very happy that I'm for both. And I'm not just the Shehu or the Emir of Pilani for only the Muslim. No, for all the inhabitants of this state. That kind of my reaction will radiate to the people in the town, and that changed a lot of misgivings. People have already corrected many things since I came here. They now know that I'm Abraham, the father of all religions of the world.
Your Royal Highness, we thank you for your time.
Okay.
And we thank you for watching. Please join us next time when View from the Top returns. But between now and then, let's continue the conversation online at channelstv.com. And do tweet me your thoughts at @ModileySY. We leave you now with sights and sounds from the palace of the Emir of Ilorin.